This section, Tree Fruit Growth and Culture, will describe some of the reproductive plant parts of apple, pear, sour cherry, plum, apricot, and peach. We will then continue with the culture of the tree fruits grown in Iowa. Tree fruits are perennial plants with deep, extensive root systems. The branches from the main trunk of the tree are called primary scaffolds and comprise the basic tree framework. Apples are the most important and best adapted tree fruit in Iowa. Let's begin the discussion of the apple by taking a closer look at the buds. The apple tree contains two kinds of buds, vegetative and mixed. The vegetative bud contains only vegetative growth, such as the leaf growth. The mixed buds contain both flowers and vegetation. The mixed bud is commonly called a flower bud. Flower buds are usually born at the tip or terminal location on shoots or short shoots called spurs. However, some flower buds are born on lateral buds of one-year-old shoots. Floral initiation occurs in early summer for the next year's crop. The apple flower bud contains 5 flowers and is determinate. Determinate means that the central flower opens first. This central flower is often referred to as the king blossom. Pear buds are similar to apple except for 2 differences. The pear bud has 6 or 8 flowers and is indeterminate. Indeterminate in the pear means that the side flowers open first and the terminal flower opens last. Pear flower buds are formed on the terminals of shoots and short spurs of 2-year-old and older wood. The next tree fruit, sour cherry, produces lateral buds unmixed with 2 to 4 flowers. The buds are present on 2-year-old wood or at the base of 1-year-old shoots. Sour cherry flowers usually open late enough in the spring in Iowa not to be killed by frost. Plums initiate flowers in lateral buds of current season shoots and new growth on older spurs. Each bud produces 1 to 3 flowers but no leaves. All terminal buds are vegetative. Fruit buds on apricot trees are on both 1-year-old shoots and on short older spurs. The solitary flowers have no basal leaves and are borne only on lateral buds. Apricot flowers bloom very early and are usually damaged by spring frosts in Iowa. The peach produces a single flower from an unmixed axillary bud on last season's growth. When selecting fruit wood to save, the 1-year-old shoots that have about 10 to 18 inches of growth in the previous season are generally the most productive. Although many of us enjoy fresh peaches, peach trees are not reliably winter hardy in Iowa. In southern Iowa, in protected locations, peach trees can only be expected to produce a crop once every 4 or 5 years. The vegetative tree parts are not very winter hardy, and the flower buds are less hardy. Fruit buds usually are severely damaged by temperatures at minus 11 degrees Fahrenheit and may be killed at minus 25 degrees Fahrenheit. Peach trees are very short-lived in Iowa, often living only 6 to 8 years, and are highly susceptible to attack by borers, virus, and bacterial diseases. We prefer recommending the other tree fruits that can grow well in Iowa with appropriate care, such as apple, pear, sour cherry, and plum. Next, we will discuss the culture of tree fruits. The cultural practices will be appropriate for all tree fruits, but we will emphasize the apple since it is the most widely planted tree fruit in Iowa. We will begin with establishment of the planting and continue with soil management, harvesting and storage, and pest management. Pruning and training of tree fruits will be discussed in one of the next segments. Apple trees should be obtained from a commercial nursery. Order trees only from reputable nurseries that offer the desired selection of cultivars and rootstocks. The price of the trees is usually determined by their size, which is measured both by caliper and tree height. Caliper is the trunk diameter 2 inches above the graft union. The best sizes of trees for planting are from 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch caliper and 4 to 7 feet tall. Branch trees larger than this are more costly and may transplant with difficulty. Branch trees are not always more desirable than unbranched ones because many branches may be broken in shipping or be poorly placed with regard to training of the scaffolds. It is usually more desirable to develop and select your own branches. Branch development will be defined later in the pruning and training segment. Avoid purchasing trees smaller than 1/2 inch in diameter. They may be small because of a poor graft union or simply because they were not given adequate growing conditions in the nursery. Begin preparation of the soil at least a year prior to planting. If the tree site has not been cultivated, plow or dig by hand the area where the tree or trees will be located. A garden crop that would be harvested by late August would help control perennial weeds. Take a soil test during the growing season prior to planting. Soil testing at this time allows for any deficiencies to be corrected before planting. The planting design of tree fruits will depend upon the fruit crop, the cultivar vigor, the rootstock, soil type, and soil fertility, and the water availability. Because of the wide range of size-controlling dwarfing rootstocks and various sizes of fruiting cultivars, it is best to use a guide provided in PM672B, Planning and Managing a New Commercial Orchard. This guide provides suggested planting distances for cultivars and rootstocks commonly grown in Iowa. For example, a medium-sized fruiting cultivar, such as Golden Delicious or Chieftain, when grafted onto Mauling 7 semi-dwarfing rootstock, would require a 12-foot by 20-foot spacings. One of the most common mistakes is planting trees too close together. It results in trees growing together so they are difficult to maintain even by annual pruning. Many fruit plantings with trees too close together end up having every other tree removed. This is a costly procedure and can be avoided by careful planning of tree spacing. Pollinizer trees should be planted in the home orchard in a design that is both practical and that ensures pollen transfer from the pollinizer cultivar to the other cultivars. Fruit set is often best on trees growing aside of the pollinizer trees, especially in seasons with poor pollination weather. The best way to ensure good cross-pollination is to plant so that each cultivar is relatively close to the pollinizer cultivar. Planting as early as possible in the spring is recommended in Iowa. Fall planting may expose the plants to winter temperatures before they have developed adequate roots. Also, spring planting helps to ensure that the trees go into that first growing season in good condition. Trees may be planted by hand. Make the planting holes slightly larger than the root systems of the trees. Position trees in the planting holes so that they lean slightly into the prevailing summer wind, which is usually the southwest. This helps to reduce tree leaning due to the wind. The roots should be spread out in the planting hole and the tree positioned so that the graft union is 2 or 3 inches above the ground level. Some settling of the soil around the planting hole may occur. Be careful not to let the scion, the fruiting portion above the graft union, become covered with soil. Scion rooting may occur and the desirable effects of the rootstock will be lost. If the trees are planted with more than 2 or 3 inches of the rootstock exposed, winter injury problems may occur in the rootstock. When filling in the planting hole, firm the soil in place to ensure good root contact with the soil and reduce settling of the soil. Water and prune trees after planting. Adjustment of the height of the graft union can be made during watering. Now that we've discussed the many aspects of planting trees, let's continue on with several soil management aspects. The first is weed control. Weed control around trees is essential for trees to make satisfactory growth. Without control, competing weeds use moisture available to the tree and may severely limit the growth of young trees. Weeds growing around the trunks of trees also provide cover for rodents and may contribute to rodent damage. The second soil management practice is fertilization. Use soil testing prior to planting to correct any deficiencies. Do not fertilize at planting because fertilizer can burn the young trunk and kill the tree. If nitrogen is needed, fertilize about 2 weeks after planting and place the fertilizer around the perimeter of the planting hole. Nitrogen fertilizer is neither necessary nor desirable in Iowa when trees are making adequate new growth each year. Non-bearing trees should make 15 to 30 inches of new growth per year. The bearing trees should have 8 to 15 inches of new growth depending on the cultivar. Trees making less than the desired amounts may be receiving inadequate nitrogen or lacking in other nutrients. They may be under water stress or may need pruning. When a need for nitrogen exists, the recommended rate is 1/10 pound of actual nitrogen per year of tree age. For example, a 3-year-old tree would receive 3/10 pound of nitrogen. There is a maximum of 1 pound of nitrogen per year for a 10-year-old or older tree. Fertilization should be done early in the spring in an area under the drip line of the tree. Always avoid fertilizing with nitrogen after midsummer because this may stimulate late fall growth that is more susceptible to winter injury. The last soil management factor for tree fruits in the home garden is irrigation. The importance of providing adequate water to a young tree cannot be overemphasized. The young tree does not have an extensive root system during its first few years of growth. Water stress in the early years severely limits the amount of annual growth a tree can make. Reduced tree growth may require more years to develop an adequate tree structure before allowing fruiting. Severe drought also reduces flower bud development, predisposes trees to winter injury, and can actually kill young trees. Young fruit trees are similar to other horticultural crops in that they require approximately 1 inch of water per week, either from rainfall or supplemental irrigation. Irrigation for a mature fruit tree may not be needed. It does, however, depend on the soil type and root development of the tree. In general, mature trees are deep-rooted and can withstand minor drought conditions. The next cultural practice that is important in tree fruit production is thinning. Fruit trees should be thinned to ensure regular annual cropping. Apple trees should be fruit thinned within 35 days after full bloom. Remove all fruits so that one apple remains on every fifth spur. Having only one fruit on every fifth spur will provide a full crop. The next cultural practice is harvesting and storage. For the highest quality apples, the fruit should be harvested at the proper stage of maturity. At harvest, the best quality apples are firm, unblemished, crisp, juicy, well-colored, and good-flavored. Apples harvested too early are astringent, sour, starchy, and poorly flavored. On the other hand, fruit harvested too late becomes soft and mealy and will not store well. To maintain the quality of apples that were harvested at peak maturity, they should be refrigerated immediately at 32 degrees Fahrenheit and stored at 90% relative humidity. If apples are held at room temperature, they soon become overripe, soft, and mealy. Two storage disorders of apples can occur in Iowa. The first is water core. Water core can develop in the field or in storage. Apples that are exposed to the sun and develop a high internal temperature during the day are most susceptible. Water core develops in the area around the vascular bundles of the core line. The cells in this area will have a glossy appearance. Water core can be a sign of overmaturity and is prevalent in red delicious apples when they are left on the tree to develop a red color. To prevent water core, harvest the fruit early at the minimum stages of maturity. The second storage disorder that can occur in apple in Iowa is Jonathan spot. It is a skin disorder associated with calcium deficiency in Jonathan apples, but other cultivars as well develop Jonathan spot. The skin around the lenticels, those small spots on the skin, develop dark-colored sunken spots. This occurs on fruits when stored for an extended period of time. It is more prevalent in some years. To control, harvest fruit as soon as it reaches minimum maturity and place it in optimum cold storage immediately. The next practice, pest management, is a major component of tree fruit production. The consumer presently expects a high-quality, blemish-free apple. As a result, an excellent pest management program is necessary for the commercial orchard. However, for home use, perhaps a less stringent pest management program can be tolerated. It would be necessary to follow and maintain a pest management spray program in Iowa to obtain blemish-free fruit. The Home Fruit Spray Schedule, PM 175, lists the current recommendations for pest control. When using pesticides, always read and follow the label carefully. Most of the insects and diseases affecting the foliage and fruit of apple damage both non-bearing and bearing trees. Among those most likely to be a problem with apple diseases are apple scab, cedar apple rust, powdery mildew, and fire blight. Insects causing injury are codling moth, apple maggot, mites, and aphids. The past few years, Iowa apple growers have experienced considerable winter injury. It is often exhibited by trunks or scaffolds being split with bark peeling. Gradually, the upper tree branches and scaffolds may die. The following cultural practices that I will list can help in preventing winter injury. First, avoid late summer fertilization that stimulates new succulent growth in late summer. Trees should cease growing in late summer or early fall in order to harden off properly for winter. Second, maintain healthy foliage on the trees throughout the growing season so that the trees go into the fall in good condition. Third, paint tree trunks in the fall with a 50% mixture of interior white latex paint and water to prevent sunscald injury to the trees. Sunscald is thought to be caused by freezing and thawing in the trunks as a result of heating during the sunlight hours, followed by rapid freezing at night. Four, try to prevent trees from entering winter under stress conditions due to excess moisture or drought. And finally, number five, train trees with good branch angles. Narrow branch angles are more subject to winter damage.